So once this graft combination is healed, this scion is going to begin growing as well as the top portion of the rootstock. And what we do after this is showing really strong growth, we'd come in and remove kind of incrementally pieces of the rootstock until we got down eventually to something that looked like that.
Wow.
And keep in mind at that stage of this top portion of the graft, this scion would be fully leafed out and growing quite happily.
Mm-hmm. Why incrementally?
If you do it too quick, it can often lead to graft failure because it's asking too much of this scion all at once. So by doing it incrementally and seeing how the scion responds, it allows for higher graft success.
So are you ever going to want to leave the rootstock on?
Yeah, absolutely. It's actually good for the health of the scion because it's able to draw energy from the top portion of the rootstock. If you picture this completely leafed out, it's capturing energy from the sun through photosynthesis, and the scion is able to use some of that energy to help it develop and heal. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you don't want to leave it on there forever. You'd have a pretty funny looking tree.
Do you ever do that on purpose to have multiple tops?
I have an apple tree at my house in my property that has about 20 different types of apples all on one tree, which is a novelty but it also has a function for people. If you have a small property but you want to grow a diversity of apples, as an example, you can do that.
Can you talk about the history of grafting?
Yeah, grafting is actually a really ancient technique. It's been known since the BC times. Theophrastus and Aristotle both wrote about grafting extensively. It was initially developed as a means to propagate plants that you couldn't grow from cuttings or seed reliably. Fruit trees, nut trees were grafted historically, initially just for food crops, for producing food crops, but it branched out and evolved into all sorts of ornamentals as well. And it's used extensively today. A huge proportion of our street trees and our ornamental trees are the result of grafting techniques.